This screencast is going to be about significant figures, or sig figs as we call them. And the first thing is how to describe them. How many do you have? And the definition is the digits from the first non-zero digit, that is to the left. And then from there, you go either to the last digit on the right, if there's a decimal point, or if there isn't a decimal point, so we have no decimal point, then it's the last non-zero digit of the number. So let's take a look at some examples. Let's say we have 4,500. No decimal point. So from the first non-zero to the left to the last non-zero, since there's no decimal point, and that would mean we have two sig figs. All right. However, if we put a decimal point here, now we have to count all four of those numbers. So that's four significant figures. Now we write it like this, 0.045. So here we have two significant figures. However, if we put a zero after that five, now that zero becomes a significant figure. So let's say we want to write this in scientific notation. This would be 4.5 times 10 to the third. However, this would be 4.500 times 10 to the third. This would be 4.5 times 10 to the minus 2, but this one would be 4.50 times 10 to the minus 2. So look at the difference that not only a decimal point makes, but also a zero following the last digit after a decimal point. So now you know how many significant figures there are. What happens if we want to multiply or divide two or more numbers? How many significant figures do we report in the answer? And what we do is we report the lowest number of significant figures in any of the numbers we're multiplying or dividing. And this does not include conversion factors. So, for example, if we multiply 4.3 times 5.27, in our calculator, we get 22.661. But that's not what we report because this has two significant figures. This has three significant figures. The lowest number of significant figures is two, so this ends up being 23. Now let's look at it in terms of dividing. So we take 6.89, we divide it by 1.357, and in our calculator we get 5.07737, etc. However, this has three significant figures, this has four. The lowest number of significant figures we have is three, so this is 5.08. Now let's look at addition or subtraction. And this has to do with the position of the last significant figure relative to the decimal point. So we report the one that's furthest to the left after the decimal point. So let's take a look at something like 83 minus 4.67. And our calculator gives us 78.33. However, If you look at this number to the right of the decimal point, we have zero significant figures, even though this has two. So we can have no figures to the right of the decimal point. So we report this as 78. And finally, let's do a combination. We have 1.03, and we add to it 4.734, and we subtract from it 0.2, and we're left with 5.564. This has two figures after the decimal point. This has three, but this has only one, so we have to report it as 5.6.